Apache Airflow is one of the most important skills you need to know as a data engineer. Big companies like Google, Microsoft, Meta, Netflix uses Apache Airflow to build data pipeline and process their data. In my career, I worked on so many different data engineering projects, and we have used Apache Airflow to orchestrate data pipeline. Orchestration means executing different tasks in sequence order. For example, let's say if you want to build a weather data pipeline, we will have different tasks such as extract data from the APIs, transform that data, and then load this data onto some target location. Now, when we execute all of these different tasks into a proper sequence, that is called as an orchestration. So Apache Airflow is an orchestration and workflow management tool. But here's the thing, when I was learning about Apache Airflow, I learned it hard way. I had to refer multiple blogs, videos, courses just to understand basics of it. But in real world, you need to know a lot of different things. You need to know more than basics. A few months back, I made this video on Learn Apache Airflow in 10 minutes. It has more than 150k views already, and a lot of people requested me to make a detailed course on Apache Airflow. Presenting you ultimate course on workflow orchestration using Apache Airflow for data engineering. This video is divided into these sections. Let's start by understanding the structure of the course. I have divided the course syllabus into multiple modules. You'll get 3 mini projects and 2 end-to-end projects on AWS and Google Cloud platform. Once you start the course, first we will start by understanding the basics of Apache Airflow. We will understand about what is data pipeline, in-depth understanding of Airflow and the architecture. We will also talk about reasons to choose Airflow and not to choose Airflow. Once you learn the basics of Airflow, we will learn about Docker. Yes, you heard it right. You might ask, Darshil, this is the Apache Airflow course. Why are we even learning Docker in the first place? The answer is, if you want to become a data engineer, you need to learn Docker. And one of the ways you will create the infrastructure for Apache Spark or Airflow or Kafka, anything, you will be using Docker image or the Docker Compose file. So I will teach you Docker from the scratch. There are around 3 videos from basics to advanced to teach you about the Docker. So in the Apache Airflow course itself, you will learn about the Docker. This is the add-on value that you will get. So even though you are just coming to learn about the Apache Airflow, you will also learn about the Docker from the scratch. Once you learn about the Docker, you will understand how to install and set up Apache Airflow in your local machine. Once we do that, then we will start deep diving onto the core Apache Airflow. First, we will understand everything about the Airflow UI. Airflow has the rich UI, so you need to understand different parts of it, how to monitor DAG, how to create DAGs, how to create connection with the external system. So all of these different things we will understand about the Airflow UI. Once we understand the UI, we will directly do a mini project. Okay, before we even understand about the different parts of Airflow such as DAG, task, operator and all of the other things, I will directly make you jump in the Airflow, so that you gain the confidence that you can write Apache Airflow code by yourself. Once this mini project is complete, we will understand the difference between task and the operator. After this, we will do the second mini project. And while doing the second mini project, we will understand about the scheduling in Apache Airflow. This is the most confusing part for a lot of people, because understanding scheduling in Apache Airflow has a lot of different concepts attached to it, and I will make all of these concepts easier for you. Then we will understand about the incremental data loading, so how to load data incrementally as the data are coming. Then we will understand about the backfilling. So when you work in an organization, there are certain times that you might have to backfill the historical data because business team has a requirement, right? So we will also understand about that. After this, we will learn about one of the most important concepts in Airflow: atomicity and idempotency. These are the two most important concepts that you need to keep in mind while building your data pipeline. So these are just basics. Now we will move to some intermediate concept. Then we will understand about the templating in Airflow, so how to dynamically schedule your data pipeline. We will learn about the branching, fan in, fan out. These are some of the intermediate to advanced level concepts that I would like to cover, because you will be using these things in the real world. After that, we will learn about the XCOM that are used to pass the data between different tasks. We will also learn about the task flow API. This is just a Python version of XCOM that you can use to pass data between different tasks. And on top of that, we will learn how to trigger Apache Airflow using external API. Okay, this is just intermediate. Now we will focus on advanced topics. And here we will start with our third mini project, where we will build simple pipeline for PostgreSQL. put the data to the S3, okay, and transform some of the data in between. This is where you will learn about how to connect with the external system and build a data pipeline. This will be your third mini project where you will learn about Postgres, S3, and APIs and build a simple mini project. On top of that, we will also understand how you can build your custom operators, tasks, and hooks. Once you start the course, you will understand about all of these terminologies. Once this is done, we will talk about how to write clean code and the best practices of Airflow, how to run Apache Airflow in production, and how to set up Apache Airflow on cloud, such as on AWS, GCP Cloud Composer, and astronomer.io. These are the three different modules from basics, intermediate to advanced to give you the proper understanding of Airflow. After these three modules, you will become master in Airflow. But we don't stop here. We have many more things to come. We are going to do our first end-to-end project, that is building a Spotify data pipeline. Now, this project we have done in our previous courses also. So if you already have been following me, you'll know that we did this project in Python for data engineering course, where we use simple Python to build the entire pipeline. After that, we also built this project in our data warehouse Snowflake course, where we replaced the loading part with the Snowflake database. Apache Spark course, we replaced the Lambda part with and added the Apache Spark glue for the transformation. And now in Apache Airflow course, we will be using Airflow to build the entire pipeline. We will execute this single project two different ways in Airflow itself. In the first approach, we will build the complete data pipeline just using Apache Airflow only, where we will write the detailed tag to extract data from Spotify data, transform it and load it onto the Snowflake. Second approach that we will use is orchestrate this entire data pipeline just using Apache Airflow. So in the first approach, we will completely use the Apache Airflow to build the DAG, okay? But in the second approach, we will keep our services such as Lambda and Apache Spark as it is, but we will use Apache Airflow just to orchestrate, okay? Orchestrate, we understood that we want to execute these different things into the proper sequence. So we will use Apache Airflow to do that. So you will execute one simple project in two different ways. And I have also added the Spotify data pipeline project from the Python course here as a reference. So if you are just starting from the course from Apache Airflow, you will get the reference about the Spotify data pipeline using Python in this course also. This is just the first end-to-end project. After this, we will do the second end-to-end project on Google Cloud platform using Cloud Composer, that is a managed version of Apache Airflow. Okay, this is the architecture. You will work with the crypto data. We will extract the different information about crypto data at every 5 to 10 minutes, store the raw data and process it using the Apache Airflow. This time we will use the managed service on GCP call as a Cloud Composer. Here we will load our data onto BigQuery and build dashboard at the end to understand everything. We will be working with the real-time data of the crypto API. So everything that is happening in the real world at that moment, you will be fetching that real-time data. On top of this, I also added some bonus projects such as Twitter data pipeline that is available on my YouTube channel. So you can also do that while doing this course. We are not done yet. This is just the Airflow part. I have also partnered with some of the modern data pipeline tools. And one of the tools that you will learn is mage.ai. So there are some few videos and the projects available to learn. I'm also talking with some of the other modern data pipeline companies. If they are willing to add their content to this course, then you will get to see in the course itself. And once you finish this entire thing, then I will show you how you can put this in your resume. It took me around 4 to 5 months to build this entire course. I have referred multiple books, courses, and the blogs to build this amazing course for you. So instead of you going from multiple directions, you can just sit, watch one course and learn everything about Apache Airflow from start to end and have two different end-to-end projects and three different mini projects executed in your portfolio. Now let's talk about the bonuses you will get from the course. First bonus you will get is the detailed notes on each and every topic that we are going to learn in the Apache Airflow. These notes, you can access it anywhere in the world and you will have access to all of these notes for the lifetime. Not only this, you will get access to all of the data engineering notes available on my course section. So you can easily go through like Python, SQL, data warehouse, jump between different topics if you want to quickly revise it. All of these notes I have built by myself. I sit, research all about all of these different topics and put all of this information at single place so that you don't have to waste your time. Okay. So these are some of the golden notes you will find for the data engineering, and I urge you to always use it to revise something and find the information that you're looking for. Second bonus you will get is the access to the data engineering data with your community so that you can share your learnings, you can talk to other people. If you have any questions or issues, you can also ask it on the Discord server. If you stay active and if you help someone else, someone will help you too. Okay, so it is very important. Community is run by people. So if you give something back, people will also give you some. Third bonus you will get is the huge discount on the future courses. So future courses that are launched on the Kafka and the cloud computing platform, I usually give up to 60-70% to my existing student. Now let's talk about what are the prerequisites required for this course. If you remember, if you have been following me till now, that I'm building all of these courses step by step. The first course we did is Python for data engineering. Second course we did SQL for data engineering. Third course was data warehouse using Snowflake for data engineers. Fourth course is Apache Spark using Databricks for data engineers. Fifth course is Apache Airflow, right? Workflow orchestration, Apache Airflow for data engineers. So I expect you to at least know basics of Python and SQL. If you don't know about, let's say, data warehouse or Spark, it is fine. It is recommended that you know, but mandatory prerequisite for this course is understanding of Python and SQL. If you don't know, because Apache Airflow is completely developed in Python, okay, we will be writing all of our DAG and every single piece of code in Python and some things in SQL. So you should know basics about it. Other than that, you don't really need to know anything, because I will teach you from scratch everything in the course itself. And if you're interested in buying the 5 course combo pack, I will also tell you about that, and you will find the link in the description about that too. Now let's talk about how to access the course and frequently asked questions. Once you make the purchase of the course, you will get the link on email and your WhatsApp also. So you just have to log in and you can just start watching your course. You will get the lifetime access to the course and all of the materials. So once you make the purchase, you can watch all of these courses as per your convenience. The other important things are, this course is completely recorded with the high quality production. I always research, I prepare all of the notes, okay, I record, I edit some of the things so that you don't have to waste time looking at the useless information, and you get the good watching experience of the entire thing. Unlike most of the people you will see in the market who just directly sell you the Zoom recordings. Zoom recordings are the worst way to learn, because you don't really understand what is going on here. Like, there are some people asking doubts, the speaker is not really focused, he is just explaining things, it's not really interactive, okay? But in the recorded session, I try to keep things crisp so that you just get the quality education. Now the question is, are these 5 courses enough to become a data engineer and get a job? The answer is yes and no. Yes, because these are the major things you need to know as a data engineer. So if you build your own project and start working in a portfolio, there are chances that you will get the job. And no, because some of the other things you might have to learn. So about Apache Kafka, and you will also have to learn about the cloud platform. So I'm currently working on building the Apache Kafka course, and in future you will also get the cloud computing courses available onto the platform too. If you have more questions about the course, feel free to comment it. I will happy to answer you. So here's the thing, if you're interested in buying the Apache Airflow course, you will find the link in the description. And if you're also interested in buying the combo pack, okay, where you will get all of the 5 courses available. Then also you can check the link in the description and you will find everything that you need to know. But still, if you have any questions, then feel free to ask me on the comment section. I have worked very hard to build all of these courses, and you will find the projects that were built by the previous students and the reviews by them. I hope to see you in the course. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see you in the next video.